everyone. Today we're talking about a medication that is gaining a lot of attention in the chronic illness community. It is called LDN, stands for Low Dose Naltrexone. Hi, my name is Dr. Kara Wada. I am a quadruple board certified pediatric and adult allergy, immunology, lifestyle medicine physician, and life coach. I'm also someone who lives with chronic illness and autoimmune disease. So you may have heard about LDN from online forums, in your support groups, or maybe even from a friend. There's a lot of buzz around it, and it's for good reason. It's being used for a wide range of conditions, from chronic pain to autoimmune conditions. But what exactly is it, and how does it work? Let's dive into the science behind low-dose naltrexone, discuss who it might help, and talk about some important safety information that you need to know. Now, as always, I may be a doctor, I am not necessarily your doctor, so you always need to be checking with your own healthcare team when it comes to making decisions about your health. So what is low-dose naltrexone? First, it's important to understand that low-dose naltrexone comes from using smaller amounts of a FDA-approved medication called naltrexone. The standard dose of naltrexone typically is 50 to 100 milligrams daily, and it is FDA approved to treat opioid and alcohol dependence. So what does this mean? It works by blocking opioid receptors in the brain and the body and helps those who are in recovery from opioid and alcohol dependence stay in recovery. And it works really well. It's also been proven to be quite safe at those 50 to 100 milligram doses daily. So what does it mean to take lower doses of naltrexone? So LDN is a tiny fraction of that dose. For most patients, that will range from 1.5 up to about 4.5 milligrams. Now, I will say in my patient panel, I have one patient who has found 0.75 milligrams to be her great dose. I have a couple of patients that I've inherited that are in 7 milligrams daily. So there is some wiggle room and a range of what folks may find most beneficial. Because the dose is low, it works in a different and a pretty fascinating way. It's important, though, to note that the use of low-dose naltrexone for the treatment of pain and inflammation is considered off-label, meaning that it is not approved by the FDA for the treatment of these specific conditions. So how does LDN work? It is a paradoxical effect. So the magic of low-dose naltrexone lies in this paradoxical effect. It works by briefly and partially blocking your body's opioid receptors, which are found not only on your nerve tissues, but also on white blood cells. Our body's endogenous opioids, which include endorphins, enkephalins, and dynorphins, are a way that our body's nervous system and immune systems can communicate with one another. When we partially block these opioid receptors, our body gets the signal temporarily to say, hey, we are not getting enough of these natural pain-relieving chemicals. So in response, your body ramps up its production of our own endogenous opioids, like the endorphins, those wonderful feel-good chemicals that you get if you go on a run and get that runner's high. So after the LDN wears off, that temporary blocking wears off, you're left with a higher level of your body's own natural painkillers. It's believed to be the primary reason for its pain-relieving and anti-inflammatory effects. But that's not all. Low-dose naltrexone also has some immunomodulatory effects. It helps regulate the activity of immune cells like T cells and B cells, mast cells, and microglial cells. Microglial cells are immune cells in your brain and nervous system, and this then can turn down neuroinflammation and the production of pro-inflammatory cytokines like TNF-alpha and interleukin-6. It does this by down-regulating some of the activity through our toll-like receptors. It does this in a way that does not increase the likelihood of us catching more infection. It does not make us immune compromised. TNF-alpha and interleukin-6 are major players in many autoimmune and chronic pain conditions. So this can be really helpful. Who is most likely to benefit from low-dose naltrexone? Based on the current research, LDN seems to be most helpful for patients with chronic conditions where chronic inflammation, immune system dysregulation, and central sensitization play a big role. Central sensitization is when your body is receiving pain signals from the brain, but then feeling them out in the other parts of our body. So the strongest evidence for its use is in fibromyalgia, multiple sclerosis, Crohn's disease, chronic pain syndromes like painful diabetic neuropathy, and certain dermatologic or skin conditions. There is also some emerging evidence that this may be helpful in long COVID as well. Who is less likely to benefit? It's also important to understand, okay, where are the holes in our medical evidence and trials? Patients who have pain that is primarily from direct tissue damage, like osteoarthritis, have shown limited to no benefit in clinical trials. And the benefit for fibromyalgia in some of these trials is modest and isn't seen in every patient. So it's not a magic bullet, but for the right patient, it can be a helpful tool to consider. What are the side effects and potential drug interactions that you need to know about? One of the most appealing things about low-dose naltrexone is that it has an excellent safety profile. We have data from thousands and thousands of patients who have taken it that really show the side effects are generally mild and infrequent. The most common are vivid dreams or insomnia. Often this resolves within a week or two, and taking the dose in the morning rather than the evening can be quite helpful. Headaches and mild gastrointestinal upset are also a little more commonly reported. The most important drug interaction we need to know about, though, is its interaction with opioid medications. Because LDN blocks the opioid receptors, if you take it at the same time as an opioid pain medicine, like a hydrocortisone or an oxycodone or medications that would be used for anesthesia, it will block the effect of pain medication and potentially, if someone is on those pain medications regularly for a very long-term painful condition, it could trigger withdrawal symptoms. So generally speaking, patients often will not take LDN and opioid medications together. That being said, again, you need to work with your own healthcare team, and there sometimes are some workarounds in situations where it's not a one-size-fits-all and can talk through things and that nuance that's so important in going through personalized care. It's crucial to discuss all your medications with your doctor before starting something like low-dose naltrexone. So what's my approach? In my practice, I see low-dose naltrexone as a valuable tool in our toolkit, especially for those patients who haven't found relief with more conventional therapies. It really fits beautifully into a more holistic approach because it works by modulating the body's own systems rather than just suppressing symptoms overall. Conditions like Sjogren's, where neuropathy is often a driving factor, mast cell activation, which will sometimes come along with chronic itching, which many times may be neurologically related just as much, if not more, than, you know, kind of what we would think of as allergy related. And for patients with dysautonomia, things like POTS, where there are some overlap of symptoms of pain and fatigue and neuroinflammation. We always start with a low dose. We move up very slowly and we listen carefully to how their body responds. It's really a true partnership in working together. If you're struggling with a chronic condition, if you're wondering if low-dose naltrexone might be an option for you, I encourage you to have a conversation with a knowledgeable healthcare professional. If you're looking for support on your journey, I have a couple of wonderful options for you. First, if you're living with Sjogren's, I'd love for you to join our free Success with Sjogren's Sisterhood on Facebook. Although we say sisterhood, all genders are welcome. It's a safe place to share experiences, ask questions, and find your people who truly get it. For those of you who are looking for personalized, in-depth care, you can discover the new patient packages at my practice, the Immune Confident Institute. It's where we work together to create a comprehensive, holistic plan that's tailored specifically to your unique health journey. You can find the links below for the Facebook group and my practice in the description. Have you ever tried low-dose naltrexone? What has your experiences been like? Share your story and your questions that you have in the comments below. Let's hear from one another. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell so that you are notified for more deep dives into your immune health. And until next time, we'll see you next week.